Now that we've been through the global section, we need to figure out how to assign modulators. And luckily in Alchemy, they make it pretty easy. I'm going to come up to my source again, and I'm going to get something that has a lot of harmonic content. So I'll choose a sawtooth wave. Now I only have one source activated, I can tell because it's blue. So here's my source. I'm going to choose A so I can look inside the source. And I'm going to grab myself a filter. So how would I assign a modulator to control cutoff? All I have to do is click on the knob, come down here to my target. See, target's already selected. Select on. And then I can choose between any of these modulation sources. We have LFO, AHDSR, MSEG, sequencer, note property, perform, envelope follower, and none. None is turned off. Now let's go to an LFO. So I'll choose LFO 1. So this LFO was previously created. It was the default LFO that came with this instrument. I can see that I've got the trigger on, so it's going to start the LFO basically every time I hit a key. If I turn that off, the LFO is just free running. Now I have it in sync mode. So if I turn this down to, say, 4 bars, it's going to be a very slow rate. I come back up to cutoff, and you can see that my parameter setting now has this orange bit around it. If I turn the depth down on my modulation source, I can see that it has less influence. So let's see what's going on now. So we can see a nice little white dot. It's traveling up and down, showing us how much influence our modulation source is having over the target. Pretty cool. Now I'll go to filter 2. Filter 2 I'm going to make slightly different. I'm going to go to formant, and I'm going to choose parallel. So now my source is going to go through both this low pass filter and it's going to go through this formant. So in the formant, I want to give it a different modulation source. So if I turn the modulation source on and go to LFO, I only have one LFO. Nope, that's not true. I can make another LFO. As a matter of fact, I can make up to 16 LFOs and have them all control that. Okay, so what do I want to do for my formant? Well, let's see. I'll choose a complex wave. It's going to be almost like a pattern. Turn my cutoff down a little bit. Turn the amount up. It's going a little fast. Do something a little bit smoother. Yeah, these are a little smoother. So I'll turn the depth down so it's not quite so extreme. So that's how you assign a modulator. Now let's explore some of these modulators.
Very much like to thank Pyramind for hosting me here once again. I think this institution is really cool, and until I came here for the first time, I had never seen anything like it in my whole life.
What I think really separates us from other people who teach is that we are outrageously passionate about what we do, and especially in electronic music.
Since coming to Pyramind, I've discovered electronic music, and you know, San Francisco being a mecca for underground electronic music opened up so many doors for me and kind of blew my mind.
We cover everything from absinthe to contact. When people get to the mind-melting level, we get into modular synthesis.
Everything about Native Instruments, everything about Logic synths, down to the finest detail, we learned it all.
The fundamentals of understanding how things work, that's just essential. But then beyond that, there's so much more, and that's where it gets into just a lot of the artistic side of, like, the creative approach of why you do something, not just how.
There's a lot of schools that just, you know, they focus on the technicality of recording music, but I wanted something that would foster creativity and really help me develop as an artist as well.
Each of our genre-specific programs comes in four levels. There's a basic, an advanced, a professional, and then a master's level. And the master's level is, of course, everything we do. It's the largest and most powerful programs that we can create for you.